Hi there, Mike here. In this video, we're going to look at how we can shrink our Windows partition and give Bazzite more space when dual booting on the same drive. When we try out a new operating system, we tend to give it the minimum requirements. However, after using Bazzite for a few months, you may find that you want to give it a lot more of your total disk space, but are not quite ready to remove Windows completely. If this is you, then follow along and let's do the process together. Before we start though, as I recommend in most of my videos, back up anything important on your Windows and Bazzite partitions. Things can and do go wrong when you do this kind of disk change. We'll start on Windows and shrink our Windows partition. This is a 2TB SSD, and we'd like to leave Windows with 200 gigs or so of space. Right click on the Windows menu, click on Disk Management, now select our C drive, right click, shrink volume. It's going to shrink down to 230 gigs, that's great. Click on Shrink, and now we've got a fair amount of space to give over to Bazzite. Now we cannot move the Bazzite partition from inside of Windows or Bazzite, so I'm going to download Linux Mint. We want to go with Cinnamon Edition, and then scroll down to a mirror that is near you. I usually use Ventoy for the next part, but today I'm going to use Rufus. Let's download Rufus from the homepage. And let's grab the 64-bit version. Now let's make a bootable USB drive of Linux Mint. Just a note that everything on the flash drive will be lost. This process takes a little while, just wait for it to complete. Now that Rufus is complete, close Rufus. Let's safely eject the drive. Let's insert it again. And let's boot Linux Mint. Now that we're in Linux Mint, let's open up Gparted. Let's move all the Bazzite partitions to the left, one at a time. Alright. Now, when we click on the Apply Operations button, then it will only do the operation. Remember my warning about making a backup? And we wait for the process to complete. Under no circumstances do you want to click on the Cancel button while this is running. Also, do not reset the machine, even if it looks like the operation is stuck. Alright, now the partition is moved, let's expand it so Bazzite is using the remainder of the disk. And we can apply that. This operation will run significantly faster. And we're done. Let's do our testing. Let's restart and make sure that Windows boots. Okay, Windows looks good. Now, very importantly, let's check that Bazzite also boots. Great, Bazzite is also working. In conclusion, as you can see, we can relatively easily change the size of our Bazzite installation without having to reinstall it. Note that you can easily do the opposite of what we have just done and give more space to Windows if you wish. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe if you haven't already. If you have any feedback, please leave a comment. Hope you have a lovely day. Goodbye.